What's up, guys? Today is the day I move away from home. It's a big day. It's a really big day for my life, and I'm super excited. So I gotta pack up all my stuff. I've been living in this house in Louisville, Colorado, in the entire first 18 years of my life. This is the first time I'm moving. So I had to go through a ton of stuff that I've accumulated over my entire life, get rid of it, and I got down to the stuff that I really need. It's time to pack it up. So I'm still in sleep mode, as you can see, and it's time to glow up. All right, so we've made some progress here. I got the hoodies on deck. Hoodies, socks and underwear, towels, pants, shorts, t-shirts, shoes. The closet is ready to be relocated. And we steezed up cash with a little bit of swag, you know. Got the Mohai sweat, the indie hoodie. What's happening, motherfucker? What's up, mom? Alright, I need to take a shower. Alright, I've got to show you guys something. So, do you think all this is a lot of clothes to take to a dorm? How many bags of clothes did I get rid of out of my closet before I left?
Six.
Six trash bags of clothes before
maybe
that.
Maybe seven.
Maybe seven. Look at this. Look at this. We're going to go down to my room for a second. Come on, Cash. All right. This was my closet. Right here. See, so we have the two. There's a side one, there's side two. This entire closet was packed full of my clothes because I've lived here for 18 years and
since childhood.
Yeah, I've been buying large t-shirts for way too long. I'm still pretty much a medium, and I've been buying large t-shirts since I was like 10, so I have so many tees. I had so many tees to get rid of, but now I gotta sort through all the hats. See, I got all these hats on the strings, hats. Are you ready to go through the hats?
No.
Alright, so I switched up the flow with the hats. I'm gonna put them on paracord once I get up to my room, but I think it would destroy the hats transporting them, so we got them all, you know, organized with a little fingerboard ramp. Gotta keep the fingerboard alive up there. It's all starting to come together. Chaotic, but organized. Classic me. How do you feel about it, Karen?
I feel sick about it, bro.
Yeah, bud.
I'm gonna miss you, dog.
Straight up, you too, G. I do. Day one. I've gotta take a shower. I can't. It was so gross.
I'm cooking.
Hey, bud.
Yeah.
I wanna do pictures like we always do up front to capture the leaving, just like we did the first day of every year when you went to school.
Do it.
I'm down. Alright. Photo op complete. Now it's shower time. Alright, all better. Cleaned up now. Got the millennial going.
These quarters, so when you hold them, you know that they're for vacuuming.
Okay.
Peace out, dude.
Peace out, dude. Later, guys.
I'll see you when I come back through town.
Love you.
Love you too, doggy. That's my dude. Okay, well,
I think I have everything I need out of my room up here. I have now made a new mess, a new set scenario of organized chaos. We've got basically all the dumb stuff from my room in here. Hats, fireworks in that bag, gotta have the fireworks. Shelf, camera gear, shoes that didn't fit in the shoe bin. Clothes. And I got this table of stuff over here. More camera stuff. Stuff in the back I gotta sell. That box right there is for an Instagram giveaway coming up soon. Stay posted. So now it's time to kind of organize this a little bit and start loading it into the cars. Okay, so got most of the stuff out on the driveway ready to be loaded in the car. Right now I'm just getting all my camera gear organized and packed up. Got the mega camera bag right there to keep all my stuff in, the little mini transport bag, filters, stabilizer, X grip. So it's all kind of starting to come together right now. Let me show you guys the pile of stuff outside. It's pretty epic. This is everything I'm gonna need to fit into my dorm room here. Look at that pile. Did you look at that pile, Mom?
It's not bad.
You think that's all gonna fit in my room?
That is questionable.
It's questionable.
But considering how much stuff you have, you really pared down really good.
Right? 18 years just accumulating stuff.
Stuff.
And this is all I got left. Because after the dorm room, it's gone straight to van life, baby. It's gonna be even smaller space. My goal is to not ever need a storage unit.
That's a good goal.
I don't know if it's a very attainable one though. All right, the mail just showed up and I have two packages. So let's find out what they are. Ooh, word. These are the one wheel Hot Wheel t-shirts from the boy James Paul. Pretty sweet. A little t-shirt action. The swag from Werner for the giveaway. Werner swag for the giveaway. Stay posted. Word. Let's keep going. We've got my pile of stuff here. And I've got my pile of there. I'm gonna put that pile of shit into that pile of shit and then drive it up to my new home. I got my crank sensor replaced in my car, whatever it's called, because it wasn't starting well and it still doesn't. So let's see how long this time it takes. Too bad. Don't vlog and drive, kids. It's very unsafe. Turn the car off. Pop the trunk. All right, start loading stuff up.
I'm taking my young son, young man, and we're gonna go get gas and we're gonna head up to the springs. This is last time leaving this street as if this was where he lived.
Craziness. Also gonna get my eyebrows waxed too.
Just saying.
But we're on the road though. Let's hope we stay safe because my entire life is behind me in my car. ladies and gentlemen, here we are. Nails 2000, nails and tanning. Oh my god, mate, look out.
Better get my eyebrows waxed. This is gonna be funny. Mom and I gotta figure out our vlogging team. Get the shot. Alright. I don't know when the last time I got my brows waxed was.
When you got them threaded that time, I think was the last time.
Oh yeah, when we got them threaded. They're pretty gnarly right now. I got the unibrow going, man.
I know, that's why I'm thinking we gotta do this. The eyebrow waxing.
Did you notice how when we walked in here, every single person in this room looked at us?
Well, that's what normally that's how that happens when you come into a nail salon.
It's weird.
You, it is a little extra since I got you here.
It's true.
I also haven't been here to get my nails done for a while, so I think Nikki's mad at me.
Yes. I feel so uncomfortable in here.
Wow.
Awesome.
Cool.
Thank you. This one right here?
Video? Is it okay to do video?
To do video on what?
Of him getting his eyebrows waxed.
Oh.
Is that okay?
So,
okay.
I don't know.
All right. This will not be quite as
in
a
room.
Uncomfortable?
Is
I know.
There's a camera out in there. Do you feel those vibes?
Yeah, the vibes are not all that great.
Like, I got pretty comfortable, like, in the airport and all that stuff, just holding it in there was just like...
It's a test.
It's a test. I mean, this is most, like, one of the reasons I do this, I want to do this, is to push myself out of my comfort zone. Make it bigger. Make it better.
Do you have it on autofocus?
I do have it on autofocus.
Okay, just checking.
Camera's got horrible autofocus.
I know.
Autofocus, gang.
Just clean it up, right?
Yes, please.
Peace, we're all cleaned up. Shades back on. Awkward. Have a good one.
Thanks, bye-bye.
But Nikki, who used to do my nails, didn't even look up.
Didn't?
She instead went, "Hi, Rachel, where you been?" You know, like, why not say that? And she was just, she gave me the cold shoulder.
Because they don't know how to run a business, Mom. It's all about giving people a good time, making them want to come back, you know? So what, you went to another nail salon? Who cares?
I've been to a nail salon.
It's like having a friend that owns a restaurant, and they're like, "I cannot believe you went and ate McDonald's because you were in a rush, and because of the place you were and the money you had, you bought that food."
Whatever.
Whatever, man.
Whatever.
We'll see you guys up in the boat. Peace out. Take your life's disappointment. Hey guys, we are here in Steamboat. My parents are gonna be staying at the Steamboat Hotel, which I will be sleeping on the floor of tonight. Then I move into my dorm tomorrow. So we'll probably get all set up here. As you can see, I've been driving. My hair is all messed up, I'm all shiny. But we're here. It was quite the journey. But I'm kind of tripping. I'm like, this is my new home. This is my new hometown. Not hometown. This is my new town. But I'm excited. It's gorgeous up here. And it's a new beginning. It's a pretty intense part of my life right now. Friends. Speaking of friends and life and intense things, I'd like to give a big, massive, loving thank you to all you people that are watching this video. It seems like even when my videos just get a little bit amount of views, it's a consistent number. So I feel like there are some of you guys that are out there watching every one of my videos that come out, and you have no idea how much that means to me. You know, I don't do this for validation. I don't feel like the amount of likes and views I get on my videos judge who I am and how much I'm worth, but it's you guys basically giving me a pat on the back and a high five for the work that I do. And every like and every comment, every time you just take the time out of your life to watch a video of my life, it means the world to me. It means you appreciate what I'm doing. And just all of you guys that are gonna be there from day one, that have been there from day one, I love you guys all so much. I appreciate you all so much. And life is gonna be great. It's gonna be a cool journey, and I cannot wait for you guys to come along with me. So, on that dramatic note, let's go find my dad, who drove separately, and get settled in so we can go get some food. I gotta fix my hair. This is ridiculous. Much better. On a crappy note, check this out. So, as I was doing my hair, I noticed this on the ground. This little puddle of water that is dripping from my car. And I showed up here very recently, so that's a lot of water for just now. So, Mom, check this out. See that?
Guess where it's coming from?
Your radiator?
I have no idea. It's coming from somewhere in my car.
Well, sometimes water comes from the cooling system. That's just normal, and we've been running the air conditioner.
So it's normal for my car to just...
Yeah, that's just air conditioner condensation.
Air conditioner condensation. It's a lot of air conditioner condensation. But if that is the case, cool!
Okay.
My buddy Paul's stranded at the Greyhound bus station in Denver right now because his parents didn't come pick him up.
And then we'll call you and you can come grab us. Oh. Home sweet home. Right there.
Yeah, I guess. That looks like a great bed for me. Oh my god. Oh my god. What's up, Pabs?
Nice. What's
Thank
up?
You. I freshened
What's
up.
What's up, crazy kid?
How you doing?
I don't know, dude.
You don't know?
Yeah. You're leaving home, you're gonna live up here. I'm still trying to make sense of it.
I know.
But I'm here. I went paddling so that I could cope with it better.
That's good. That was a good move.
We fixed this up. It reminds me, I moved to Colorado, drove to Colorado with Bobby when I was 17. And did earlier than you did.
Yeah, you moved earlier than me.
One of the best times of my life, which I figure is what's happening for you. It's just that we're old parents that are trying to still look good, huh?
Aww. Oh, we still man. Look good.
We're hanging
You'd around. Look good. I don't know.
Yes, you do. Look at you. Why are you pointing that camera at me?
Alright, friends, viewers, subscribers, humans. We are going to go get some food at Low. From what I know so far, the best place in Steamboat. The night is beautiful and still young. And as much as I want you guys to join me, I want to spend a little time with my family before I move out. So I'm gonna put the camera away, eat some food, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for joining.
It's good.